York Comic Con Funko Pop hunting? Welcome to today's video, and in today's video we are going on a huge Funko Pop hunt. Not only is this New York Comic Con, it is also Triple Force Friday and the release of all the Frozen 2 pops, so I will be getting some of all of that. I'll probably only be getting one or two exclusives from New York Comic Con because a lot of the ones I want are online, so just prepare yourself for that. But I will have reviews of all of these at the end of the video. I know I want 3 Star Wars pops and then like maybe 3, maybe a little more Frozen 2 pops. So this will be a big hunt. I've been saving my money because I know it's like a huge release today. And Ethan is not going to be in this video because he's actually going on vacation today, so he could not come to the hunt. I do think I'm going to be picking up a New York Comic Con exclusive for him on Sunday when Targets come out. But yeah, now let's get on with the hunt.
We are now in the car, and our first stop is Target. We're heading over there not for New York Comic Con because their exclusives don't come out till Sunday for some reason, and it is Friday. But I'm actually going for First Friday because I want their Boba Fett pop. I know it's a collaboration, but just like the kind of camo Boba Fett, I think it looks really cool. So I'm going to get that and maybe some Frozen 2 ones if they have them or some other Star Wars ones. We'll see. But I'll take some pictures once I get in there.
So we now just finished Target and I got 2 pops. They didn't have any Frozen 2 pops, but I got the one that I went for, which was this Futura Boba Fett. It's like a collaboration with an artist and it looks really nice. They had like 18 of these. So, if you want one, you would probably be able to get it, even if you didn't come at opening. It has a nice blacked out box and a very cool design. It was $18, though, because they put it in a pop stack for some reason. I mean, I guess you're paying for the pop and the pop stack, so I guess that's why, but that was a little weird. And then they had all the Rise of Skywalker ones on this table display thing, so I got the only one I wanted, which was D.O., this seems to be the new droid, but I really wanted it because the only thing I really care about in Star Wars is the droids and the Wookiees. So I got D.O. and he's a cool new droid. And next we will go to Box Lunch where I'm actually going to get a New York Comic Con pop, which is the Kevin with the Up House. As you know, I'm collecting Pixar pops now. And that one's really cool. Even though it's like $50, it looks worth it. And I called them yesterday and they said they have 90. So I should be fine. But yeah, that's where we're headed next. So here's some stuff that Box Lunch had. They had a lot of Rise of Skywalker stuff and Frozen 2 stuff. They had a few Kevin with houses and probably a lot more in the back. They also had some of the new rides, which is cool. And they also had some stuff from Mandalorian and Jedi Fallen Order. So inside of Hot Topic, they had all of their exclusives, and they also had Rise of Skywalker ones, and I'm pretty sure they had all of them. They also had Frozen 2 and the Mystery Minis, and their exclusive Elsa, which isn't that cool in my opinion. We are now back from the mall, and I was able to go to Box Lunch and Hot Topic. We weren't able to go to FYE because it wasn't opened yet, but I got a lot of pops. I'm sorry it's loud because we're in the car, but I did get a lot of pops. I got a lot of Frozen 2 pops, and I also got Kevin with Up House, which is nice. So I'll just show you guys which ones I got. So I got Earth Giant from Frozen 2. And this is like one of the heaviest pops ever. It feels like, I don't know, it's like really heavy though. It's probably like, I don't know, maybe like 2 pounds. Actually, that might be much, but it's really heavy for a pop. And then the other one I got, another one I got from Frozen 2 is actually a 6-inch, and it is the Water Auk. I wanted this one, and it looks really cool in person, so I had to get it. And then Hot Topic was having buy one, get one 30% off. So I also got Sven because it's just too cute. And then at box lunch, I got one normal pop, which is the Mandalorian. This was the only one I wanted from Mandalorian, and I like all the colors on it. And then one thing I actually wanted, and I've seen it there before, but I decided to get it today, is this keychain of Stitch, but it's Diamond Collection. It looks really cool, and I love it, so I was glad I could get it, because they sold out before. And then and then another thing I got, which I can't pick it up with one hand. I need to show it to you guys.
So I got the Kevin with Up House at box lunch, and it is huge and very heavy.
Now we are going to the probably last store. I don't know if I'll go to GameStop or not, but we are going to Barnes & Noble, and I may get one exclusive there.
So this is what Barnes & Noble had. They had three of their exclusives. They were missing the one I wanted, but they had the other three, which is cool.
So I just went to Barnes & Noble, and they had all their exclusives except the one I wanted. Like, they only had four exclusives, and for some reason, they didn't have their Donald Duck as Firefighter, which was the one I wanted, because I like the way it looks, and, I don't know, the box looked kind of cool, actually. But they still had the other three, but I don't know. I don't know why they didn't have the Donald. That made me mad.
So, inside of GameStop, they did have all their exclusives, I'm pretty sure, but they had low amounts of most of them. So, hopefully, if you wanted stuff from GameStop, you could get it. They also had Rise of Skywalker, and I think they had most of them, and they also had a few of the Frozen 2 ones.
I just got out of GameStop, and they had all their exclusives, I think. I don't know. They only had one of the Bud Stallion, but it had a really bad box, but it was really cool. But yeah, they had all of them, as you see in the pictures. I don't know why I'm explaining, but yeah, they also had their new Pop Towns for Christmas, which were cool. Yeah, but I didn't want anything there. None of their exclusives really interested me. So, yeah, now we are going home, and I think I'm going to give you guys a closer look at some of these pops.
Okay, so this is where I'm going to give the closer looks. This is just a small table I have in my room. Right here, I have my NYCC want list, and I was able to take Kevin with Up House off. I pre-ordered both of these. Benson is actually coming tomorrow, so I will probably have a review tomorrow. I'm not sure when Iron Man's coming. I missed Stan Lee, but it restocked while I was at box lunch, and I got so close. Still don't have him, but hopefully I can get him later. And then Dwight with Bobblehead hasn't gone live yet, but right now when I'm recording. But, yeah, so I'm going to give you guys a look at a few pops that I think are cool. We'll start with this one, which is the Water Rock from Frozen 2. This one I just think looks really cool. And then we'll also do Kevin with Up House, Earth Giant, and then Mandalorian. So those are just some cool ones I want to show you guys. So let's start with Water Rock. This one says Water Knock. I keep getting this wrong. Water Knock. It is Pop Frozen 2, $5.92. And then on the back, you have the whole set. I thought this was a 6-inch, but it's not, actually. But I'm going to take this out of the box and give you guys a closer look. Okay, so here is the Water Knock. Right when I took this out of the box, it's, like, breathtaking. It's so cool. It's all just, like, a clear blue, besides the eyes, which I guess are painted in a darker blue. But it is just so cool. It seems huge. Doesn't even look like a pop at all. Just seems like it could be, like, some figure. But it's on this clear base, which is nice, and I'm definitely keeping this out of box. It looks super cool, and definitely better out of box. And, I mean, it's kind of hard to go into detail because it's all just blue, but there's a lot of cool, like, water effects, and then you see the head, the body, tail. I don't know if this is hair or not, but kind of hard to explain because I haven't seen the movie, but this is just an amazing pop overall. Okay, so now I'm going to review one of the other ones from Frozen 2 I got, which is Earth Giant. As you know, this one's extremely heavy. It is a normal pop, even though, like, it's super tall. I'm gonna go for the best for last, so that's why I'm gonna be reviewing Kevin with the Up House last. But this one is actually taped, so I'm gonna have to cut that, and it is $5.87, so just one before this. Oh, that's weird. This is 87, that's 92. I guess maybe there's some in between. Maybe exclusives. Anyway, but I'm gonna review this one and let's see all that detail. Okay, so I now took the Earth Giant out of the box
And there isn't a ton with this pop. It's really heavy, but it's just all kind of stony, like that kind of color with a ton of gray dots. He has this face with a kind of weird looking mouth, but eyes. And then there is also some little leafy green, like grass kind of things on him. I guess he just like comes out of the earth or something. But yeah, this one's a great value because of how big it is and how heavy. But it's not a super detailed pop, but maybe I'll learn to like it more once I've seen the movie and seen what this character is all about. Hello, so I'm just telling you I accidentally did the Mandalorian out-of-box look and the look at the box of the Kevin with Up house, so that it looks weird on here, but, yeah. So here's a look at the Mandalorian pop. I'm not gonna put the other ones in just because it's the wrong way and you would have to turn your head to look at it. But, yeah, here's a look at the Mandalorian pop. Okay, so now we are onto the little look at this. So first, Kevin, the pop it comes with, is a very nice character, and they did a good job with the pop. It looks just like her. And, yeah, there's a lot of colors, just making it a very nice pop. Probably one of the best ones they've made from Up. And they've been doing more Up lately, especially with, like, the Carl and Ellie 2-pack and this. But you've got the house with all the balloons, which is huge, and it's very heavy, which is why I'm not gonna try to hold it. I can, but I just don't want to. The balloons are huge, and it doesn't really look like the movie, but it still gets the message that it's trying to look like the movie. But the house is very nice with lots of colors, and they did a good job on all the details, even like this little hose that they used in the movie to like carry the house around. And then little details like this and all of this stuff, it just makes it seem very well done. And, yeah, I think they should make a new Up line, especially with it being the 10th anniversary. It's a great time to make a new line, maybe make a new Russell and a new Carl. Maybe make, Kevin's little tiny bird babies. That would be cute. But, yeah, this is very nice. One of the best things from the con, in my opinion. And I really like it.
So that is it with this video. Thank you for sticking around me. This was a long video. A big hunt. And I think it was all worth it. It was a very nice day today. A lot of great pops came out. And I got a lot of stuff I wanted. But whenever the Amazon stuff comes out. Or comes to my house. I will do reviews. And Benson's coming tomorrow. So who knows. Maybe there will be a review tomorrow. But, yeah, thank you for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, Funko Force, out.